Hey guys, it's Kevin. When you start a DTF, you're probably confused with what's capping solution, what's cleaning solution, what's weather solution. This video is sponsored by the DTFPro, or we call the DTGPro, the same company. If you go to DTFPro.com, go to clean and parts, scroll down, and then you're going to find this sampler pad. If you go to DTGPro.com, go on your left, you're going to find DTF and click on that and go to cleaning solutions. I think my order got doubled somehow. I got two pads and two sets of cleaning solutions. It came with 50 foam swabs. I'll show you how to use them later. Now let's separate them into three groups. Capping solution and the maintenance solution is the first group. The second group will be the cleaning solution. You have a regular cleaning solution, extreme cleaning solution, and the last chance cleaning solution. For the third group on itself is a de-plasticizing solution. I don't see the de-plasticizing solution listed in the pack on their website, so you may want to confirm with them. When you have something that's going to contact your printhead or is going to go into your printhead, first thing you want to do is a drop test. I'll prepare for the test and keep talking. The first group is capping solution and the maintenance solution. At the end of the day, after you finish printing or after you finish the job, you want to put some solutions inside the capping station, so keep the printhead moist. The difference between capping solution and maintenance solution is the maintenance solution is a vacation mode. So when you go on the vacation, you want to add a maintenance solution. I have a video detailed showing you how to do the wet capping, and I'm going to put a link above. Now the cleaning solution, start from the blue. The cleaning solution may get into the printhead, so this group is more important. And the capping solution and the maintenance solution will just contact the surface of the printhead. They separate the cleaning solution to three groups, regular cleaning solution, extreme cleaning solution, and the last chance cleaning solution. So just how desperate you are. Now the last group, de-plasticizing solution. This will not contact the nozzles. It's just for you cleaning the rubbish residue. For example, the rubber seal on the capping station or the rubber wiper on the capping station. We just poured out 30 mil, about 30 mil for each, and we put three drops of wet ink on it. So whatever brand of ink you use that wet ink. If you don't have a professional shaker, you can just shake by hand. I usually just do an eyeball test. Just look, see if I can see any coagulation. To be more snobby, you can put on a microscope. So both for the capping station and the maintenance solution, you can see it look like milk, and it passed our test. That's expected. However, for the cleaning solution, you have to be careful. There are lots of cleaning solutions that come in a concentrated form. So if it's concentrated, you're going to have a coagulation and kill your white ink instantly. So we test all three of the cleaning solutions from the DTFPro, and they're all safe to use. Just show you a scary example. Our cleaning solution is concentrated, so I'm going to use it without a dilution. If you don't dilute it according to the product specification, this is going to happen. So always read the description and do a drop test whenever you get any kind of new cleaning solutions. Here's the same solution, properly diluted and safe for the printhead. I don't know if it matters to you or not. I also test the de-plasticizing solution, this yellow one. Although supposedly it shouldn't go inside the printhead. However, actually this solution is also safe to use. Okay, now rubber meets the road. For the capping solution and maintenance solution, I have another video show you how you use those. For my printer here, I have double dampers. So when I print, I use the white ink damper. When I'm not printing, this tank is filled with a capping solution. I changed two dampers with a capping solution, and I print a white image that's going to get rid of all the white ink inside the nozzle. So basically, inside the printhead and on the capping station is all capping solution. So most of my printhead never clog. They still go bad, but they go bad because they're over their lifetime. Absent use of chip on film technology, there are just so many times a film can bend, so eventually the film can worn out. Probably using the capping station and the maintenance solution will just make your day very easy. And you can see this printer have printed thousands of pages already. You can come in any day, turn it on, and do 1 to 5 minutes maintenance, and it just keep printing. It's all because this clear tank, which has a capping solution. When I'm on vacation, I'm going to put a maintenance solution in it. I know it looks like a pile of crap. That's because it gets beaten down every single day. See the white ink in the capping station? And here's a TMS machine that maintains the capping station. Okay, I'll cover the de-plasticizing solution. When you print, there will be lots of ink accumulated underneath printhead carriage. You need to remove those old ink, old dry ink. Otherwise, you're going to see a small smear and very evenly spaced. Then you'll park your printhead here, and you'll try to go underneath and use the foam pad and pick out those dried ink. For my modified printer, I don't need it because every day I can park my printer here and just wipe everything off with a white paper towel and done. Just want to show you, if you do the de-plasticizing, you're basically doing this. You have ink accumulated underneath the printhead. The de-plasticizing solution will make the dried ink softer and be able to be removed. Again, DTFPro said that the de-plastic solution is not for use inside the printhead. This rubber seal is very important because it creates a vacuum and can suck ink from the printhead. So if this gets dried ink accumulated, you will not be able to clean the printhead efficiently. Also, another one is this wiper. This wiper cleans the excessive ink on the bottom of the printhead. You can see it got really easy get cleaned with the plasticizing solution. Okay, I don't clean that much because usually I don't get clogs. If I get clogs, I have automatic cleaning machine. I'm going to put a link above, and it's a TMS adapter that cleans it for me. So let me just simulate what most people do is they do the pushing method. Here your goal is to put some cleaning solution inside the printhead, but not to push anything out. So you have to be pretty gentle. You want the ink to come out like beads, not like fountains. You will do for each color and sit the printhead for 5 to 10 minutes and repeat. You'll be able to see where is clogged and where's not. And here's second round. You can see the first color doesn't have any clog at all. When a clog just gets opened by the cleaning solution, you're going to see the ink with the color coming out. Okay, get another printhead, try this. When a printhead is really good condition, the moment you put a tube on them, you're going to see the beads coming out. See this? You're going to see there's no clog on the top, but on the bottom, there's a little bit of clog. So that little bit will be helped with the cleaning solution. So I just put some cleaning solution in there. I'll let it work on it. Then I get a second channel, and the second channel was totally fine. There's no clog. 5 minutes later, you can see it's still a little bit clogged. The third time, you're going to see the ink coming out of the clog. Then I change to distilled water. Usually do not push this hard, okay? I just want to show you the beads for the video effect. Normally, I do a lot slower than this. The first print usually is pretty watery because you have still got distilled water in there. But it always feels good to see the white ink coming out. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit that.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!